Yeah, good morning all of you. Good morning to one and all. I hope everyone is good and fine. And today we are moving to the last, you can say, session of our demo lectures. Though lectures will be continued tomorrow also, day after tomorrow also, daily. But then, yeah, the YouTube live, that is for the free of cost for all the people. It will be live last session. From tomorrow, we will be giving the link only to those people who have joined the lectures. So take the benefit of this lecture to the most, right? Yeah, let me see if people are live right now. Yes, good morning, guys. Good morning, Ashish, Likhita, Praveen, Jatin Ahuja, Janrath, Janarth Prasad. Good morning, good morning. So, yeah, today is Sunday and we are supposed to cover for 1.5 hours today. And today we have a single lecture of mine only. So today we are going to discuss about the Indian Constitution, which we are going to discuss last time also, and we will continue further, right? Good morning, Achyut, Prince, Anubhav. Yesterday no class because yesterday there was not able to connect with the internet connectivity and all these things. So there was no class yesterday. Today we have a normal class. Good morning, Rani, Om, Priyanka Sharma. Good morning, guys. Good morning. So yeah, one more time I'll repeat that this is the last class of demo. And from tomorrow, the link will be given only to the private group, WhatsApp group, which has been created, where the people who have registered, they have been added, right? So we will be giving lectures tomorrow to the private people only, right? Fine, guys. So let's start with the topic today. Yesterday, we were discussing about the concept of the preamble of Indian Constitution. And then also, you remember, we discussed about the concept of the federal constitution and unitary. I hope you remember this. So we start with that. What is federal? What is unitary? And all this thing, right? So if you can come to the notes, I hope you can see on the screen the notes which we were discussing yesterday also. So what is the screen and what we were talking about is, now please understand what we're talking about is that. Now please understand what I'm going to discuss you is that the Indian Constitution, first of all, remember what I'm trying to say. The Indian Constitution has been made with the reference of multiple countries. So what do you mean by this word? It means that Indian Constitution was made in 1950. You remember this? Before that, every country used to have their own constitution. So we refer the country USA, we refer Canada, Australia, Austria, Germany, Spain. We referred to many countries, and what we did is we took the main features from the country, right? I'll give example to you. Please tell me who is a topest person in country, the apex person. If I ask you the question, is it prime minister or president? Who is a topest person in the country? Who is the most important person in the country? Anyone can tell me the answer quickly. It is also helpful to understand this chapter also and also current affairs. President or Prime Minister in our India. And also if you talk about India, side by side you also give the answer of USA and India. I'll give you what I'm trying to say. Okay, there are 3-4 answers who are saying PM, President, and only one Adesh is saying PM. Hardik Harsh is also saying PM, but majority answers are President. Okay, which angle you are saying? Okay. So majority, 80% people are going with president, and 2-3 answers are there for PM. Okay, so the first person of the country is president. The first person of state is governor, right? Is it known to everyone? So governor is the first person of the state and president is the first person of the country. So in that angle, president is the topest person. But we need to talk about the law making powers and everything. Who has the majority powers in our country? So it is with Prime Minister. But if you go to USA, do we have the concept of Prime Minister in USA? Who is Donald Trump? Donald Trump is which person? And whenever Donald Trump comes to India, he has a contract with what? The Modi or Ramnath Kovind. Now, whatever happened in India, China, who is aggressively making the statements? Whose name you are looking daily on the newspaper? whenever COVID was there for the last 4 months, who used to come in frequent intervals to the country and used to talk about this? And when you have seen the, please tell me, when you have seen the news of Ramnath Kovind in the last few days, when you have seen the news of Ramnath Kovind in the newspaper or the news channel, wherever, when you have seen, please understand, in India, we don't have a concept of president. So what you are saying, we have a president, yes, but the power making, the duties and the powers which is given is with, not in India, it's not with president, it is with Prime Minister. But you go to USA, it is president. So what I'm trying to say, I'll show you something. Then accordingly, we will go and read, right? Give me 1 minute, I'll show you something, and accordingly, I'll take you to the topic. Just a second, and I'll go with the notes. First of all, let me open the notes, and then I'll show you a PPT. Right, I'll show you a PPT, and accordingly, we will cover this, right? Right, I hope you will see this, and right, if you remember, we have discussed this all about, right, we have discussed all this thing. Now, please focus on this slide. What I'll do is, I'll make it full screen for you, right? I'll make it full screen for you so that you can only look at this slide, right? Now, you can see what we are talking about. It is written as a borrowed features of Constitution of India. So, when we made Constitution of India, we borrowed the features, because all these countries which you are seeing on the screen has been made their constitution way before 1947, before independence, right? Okay, are you able to see this? Should we go ahead? Now you see, the first is from UK, and the UK, the first word is nominal head is equal to president. So in India, the nominal head is president. So who is the head of the country? So whatever people said in the chat box, that who is the highest person in the country, answer is president. Absolutely right. But which person is a nominal. What is nominal? Nominal means naam matra. Sirf naam ke liye. Just for namesake. Nominal. Just for namesake, who is the highest person in the country? That is president. And we borrowed this concept from UK. If we would have borrowed from USA, point number two, if we would have borrowed from USA, what would be the answer? Agar humne ye borrow kahan se kiya hota? USA se. To kya hota answer? Then, in India, who would have been the best person? President. That time Modi ji fought for which election? That time Modi ji would have elected for presidentship, right? So if we would have borrowed from USA, so understand what I'm trying to just say, right? So in USA, the concept of head who is always called as president. But in UK, the main power will be given to the post of PM. So the PM post is given in UK, and US, there is nothing called as Prime Minister. Are you getting a point? Then we have a concept of Speaker in Lok Sabha. I hope you know about Speaker in Lok Sabha. Which Speaker is in Lok Sabha? Tell me. Who is the Speaker of Lok Sabha? JBL Speaker. Right. Om Birla. Sumitra Mahajan, Tushar Pahade. Yes, who is speaker of this? Many people will say, sir, first, JBL speakers. It has a good sound quality, JBL. Yeah. Yes, tell me, who is the speaker of, also we are talking in both angles, current affairs as well as, who is speaker of Sumitra Mahajan, great. Sumitra Mahajan, okay. Akshay says Om Birla. Om Birla, Sumitra Mahajan. Great. Very happy to see such answers. Speaker of Lok Sabha. Speaker of Lok Sabha. गुड, स्पीकर ऑफ लोकसभा. वेर यू वेंट रॉन्ग, सुमित्रा महाजन वॉज राइट, बट शी वॉज टिल लास्ट ईयर. टिल लास्ट ईयर सुमित्रा महाजन वॉज देयर, बट नाउ ओम बिरला इज अ स्पीकर ऑफ द लोकसभा. नाउ हियर यू लॉस्ट वन मार्क इन करेंट अफेयर्स ऑल्सो, एंड यू आर लूजिंग मार्क्स इन द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ यूर लॉ ऑल्सो, राइट? यू शुड बी अवेयर अबाउट दिस करेंट अफेयर्स. नाउ यू विल से तुषार सर, यू हैव नॉट टॉट अस ऑल दिस थिंग. इट्स नथिंग अबाउट टीचिंग एंड ऑल, इट्स जस्ट हैविंग द नॉलेज ऑफ न्यूज पेपर, वॉचिंग द न्यूज एंड ऑल दिस थिंग, राइट? प्लीज प्लीज फोकस ऑन ऑल दिस थिंग वॉट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से, राइट? Ashish is still saying Sumitra Mahajan. Ashish, please refresh your video. I guess you are watching the video in a late, like you are watching after 2 or 3 minutes, I guess. Please refresh it. Okay. So what I'm trying to say, Om Birla is a speaker, right? So like this. So this concept of speaker we borrowed from UK, right? So all these things we have borrowed from UK. Then we have a concept of, you have heard about 5-year plan. In your economics in the beginning, in 11th class, 12th class, you have heard about 5-year plan. The first 5-year plan started in 1951. If you remember, first 5-year plan started in 1951. So, where the 5-year plan started the concept was taken from USSR, right? Germany, we have a concept of emergency. Whatever is happening right now, it's a health emergency in our country. In 1975 to 77, your parents would be that time, maybe young or maybe around 15-20 years of age. In 1977, I'm talking about, you talk to your parents, and maybe if you have grandparents at your home, you ask them about 1975 to 1977. Ask them 1975 to 77. That is the biggest emergency which was there in our country. That time Indira Gandhi was the prime minister of the country, and there was an emergency that was called as the financial emergency. So the emergency is something where the parliament, the government of India, has to take the powers, and that is the situation right now. We also have tilted the concept of health emergency, right? Pandemic. So this is what we took on from. Then from Japan we took the concept of Supreme Court, right? From Canada we took the concept of federal thing. So from Ireland we took the concept of directive principles. See, Ireland, Africa, these are small countries compared to India. But then the problem is, these countries has been got the constitution way before Indian constitution. So that's why what we did is, now understand what this screen shows. This screen shows that the whenever the powers are, whenever the constitution was made, it was borrowed from multiple countries. Good features took from UK, some features took from USA, right? So everything was took from that thing. So we have a concept of fundamental rights, we have a concept of vice president. If you see the second point number, USA, the vice president, so this Supreme Court, head of the state known as president, and provision of state, judicial review, you can review your case and all this thing. So these are powers which are given by the USA. So you took something from USA, you took something from US, from Australia you took this thing, right? Language of the preamble, central state relationship. So that is how we took something from Australia, Ireland, and France, and different countries, right? So I hope you understood this example, what I am trying to show you. Now let's come back to our chapter. So we were talking about last time that this thing. Now understand what we are going to discuss again today. I'll remove everything and I'll start from beginning. And the Indian very famous case in India was Keshavanand Bharati was the state of Kerala. Very famous case. Now understand what I'm trying to say. The Constitution of India is basically federal, but having some unitary features. So if I talk about the federal features, I told you we have around 6 to 7 federal features and around 2 to 3 unitary features. So which features we have? So we have both the features, but we have majority of what? Federal with certain unitary features, right? The majority of Supreme Court judges in the case of Keshavanand Bharati versus State of Kerala, 1973 ka case tha ye, of Supreme Court. How to read the case? Keshavanand Bharati versus State of Kerala. Now remember how to read the case. What was the case? Keshavanand Bharati versus State of Kerala. So who filed the case? You have seen a movie also, Jolly Little Bee versus State. So the person who filed the case is called the plaintiff, the person who filed the case. Right. So let me tell you all this thing also, because it is also helpful for you. So the person who files a case, let's say Keshavanand Bharati versus state of Kerala. So in this case, what will happen? What will happen? This person will be called as plaintiff. So what is plaintiff? Plaintiff word is derived from the word plaint, and plaint word is derived from the word complaint. But complaint can be oral also. But when you make that complaint in writing, that will become the word plaint. Plaint, and that person who files a plaint is called as plaintiff. So the person who files a case is called plaintiff, or also called as petitioner. You have heard about the word petition, petitioner. And the person on whom case is filed is called as defendant. Defendant, or you can also called as a respondent. Respondent. So these are the words which you need to remember. Please focus on this thing. So what happened in the case? Keshavanand Bharati versus state of Kerala. State of Kerala. So in that case, Keshavanand Bharati was a petitioner. Okay, petitioner, or you can say plaintiff, who started the complaint. Let's say if I do not teach you properly, if I took fees from you, and if I do not teach you. So in that case, can you file a case on us? Yes, sir, you can file a case on us. Then the case would be, let's say, Jatin Ahuja versus Tushar Pahade. If he alone file a case on me. So Jatin Ahuja versus Tushar Pahade. So Jatin Ahuja will become the plaintiff and Tushar Pahade will become defendant, because I need to defend myself. Because whatever you are saying against me, you are filing a complaint against me, I need to defend myself that I have not did all this thing. So I will be called as a defendant, or I will be called as a respondent, because to your complaint I am responding. So I will be called a respondent, right? So this is how you need to read, understand all the cases. Whenever you will see the cases in future, we will be having so many cases. Ajay Hasia, theek hai? We will have the case of Khadak Singh. We will understand many cases in this also. When we will go to Contract Act, we have multiple cases. So whenever we will teach, I will teach you the names of the cases. Remember always, the person who files a case will be given first preference versus the person on whom the case is filed. Then we have three things, like let's say 1973. So everyone knows what is the case in the year. Then we will have SC or SC or MC, Madras court or Rajasthan court, like this. So we will have that. And then we will have some number also, like this 1461. So that is the number of case of that year, of 1973, the case number of 1461 of Supreme Court. So you can see Supreme Court has given so many judgment in that year and different cases. So this is the number of this. So 73 Supreme Court or High Court would be there, like this. Right now in our example, it is written SC, Supreme Court. Right, Supreme Court. And the remaining last word is called as AIR. What is AIR? What is AIR in, if they ask you the concept, what is AIR in the context of law? One is All India Reporter. All India Rowdy. Yeah, these are the four options to you. AIR stands for what? In the context of law. I hope you have heard about this. AIR. It is written AIR. AIR. But it's not AIR. It's full form AIR. What is full form of AIR? Anyone can guess. Is it All India Rank? All India Report? Reporter? Or All India Rowdy. So Rowdy is I know everyone can understand. I am doing time pass with these two words. These are not the answers. And All India Rank is also not an answer. All India Rank is also not an answer. Because All India Rank is very important, but not in context of law. So again, if you want, you need to go and check it out in Google. Always do this thing. AIR in context of law. What, when we say law, right, law, like this, AIR. Right, you need to go and check it out. You can always do Google, right? Yes, there are many people who are saying answer 2 or 3, either report or reporter, report or reporter, right? The answer is answer point number C, All India Reporter, reporter, right? All India Reporter. If you see like this, anywhere you can go and check it out, what is the full form of this, so you will understand the full forms of this also, right? We will give you this thing also, if you can understand. It is written everywhere, right? AIR, All India Reporter, and then we write Supreme Court, SC. So, SC is Supreme Court, like this. So, understand like this, AIR, SC, High Court, like. So, AIR is nothing but a All India Reporter, right? So, this is how you need to understand. Now, I hope you understood the whole case. What is the whole name of the case? So, like this, the name of the case is Keshavanand Bharathi versus State of Kerala. AIR, All India Reporter, 1973, the year in which the case has been fought, SC means Supreme Court, and 1461 is the number of the case. So, how, I hope you remember like this, it is an interesting thing, right? You need to remember all these things which I have taught you. Perfect. So, they were of the view, that time also they were of the view that Indian Constitution has which features? So, they said that Indian Constitution has basically which features? Federal features only, right? But then we have some features which are into which category? Unitary. So, what is the judgment? We can say that thus to decide whether Constitution is federal, unitary. So, the better answer would be it is a quasi-federal. So, let's understand, let's look at the contents. Let's see, because Tushar sir said 6 to 7 items are federal, 3-4 items are unitary. So, let's understand what are these items, right? So, the essential features of federal or system is that the government should be in India what? Dual government. Do we have dual government? Let's understand one by one. Rather than teaching you, let me ask you only. Do we have the dual government? Yes or no? Do we have the dual government? Sir, yes sir. We have central government, we have state governments. We have the level of dual government, right? Do we have the distribution of powers? Has the power been distributed to different levels? Can the state government takes the law, pass the laws on the state matters? Can the state government decide to pass the laws on state matters? Yes, sir. I gave you the example 2-3 days back also when we discussed about the concept of alcohol. When you go to Goa, alcohol is cheaper and also free flow. But when you go to Gujarat, there is a ban on the alcohol. When you go to Bihar, there is a ban on the alcohol. Now, after the death of Sushant Rajput, what Bihar government took this decision that they will ban the movies of all these star kids and all. They have passed. Now, Bihar government did, because Sushant Rajput was belonged to Bihar, and Purnia district, he belonged to that district, and he used to stay in Patna before coming to Mumbai. So, Bihar government was very much affected of this thing, and they decided, okay, we will not release the movies on this state. So, can they decide? Yes, they can decide. They can decide. Now, recently, best example is MHA, Ministry of, best example is MHA, Ministry of Health Affairs. Very beautiful example, MHA, Ministry of Health Affairs. Now, what I am trying to say, they said that malls can be open. Malls can be open. They said malls can be open. Saloon can be open. Only what cannot be open? Gym, gymnasium, movie, theater and all. But mall can be open. But in Maharashtra government, who stays in Maharashtra, they know that in Maharashtra, saloon, malls, all are still closed. But if you go to some other states of the country, they have opened. They opened because of the number of cases. So, who decided that, okay, in Maharashtra, we will not do? So, Maharashtra government decided. Hyderabad, then that is Telangana, or Andhra Pradesh, the law will be different. Tamil Nadu, the law will be different. Kerala, the things would be different. Chandigarh, things would be different. Pashchim Bengal, things would be different. Recently, Pashchim Bengal, the Kolkata, the West Bengal decided that no flight will come to Kolkata. No flight will land to Kolkata. If I again show you quickly in Google as usual, because I am very much fond to show you the practical examples, right? Flights to Kolkata. The moment I write Kolkata, you can see the news. You can find the news. I hope you can see this news. Last yesterday's news only is there from 6th to 19th. July, no flights will operate to Kolkata from six cities. Now, who decided this? sir, government of Kolkata. Sir, you will not land our flights, your flights in Kolkata. 2 weeks halt on flights to Kolkata from six cities with big caseload, which has the cases. Right. So, they have recently told all this thing. So, what I am trying to say, these examples are coming under which category? Now, you understand there are six cities which are there. Out of this, Nagpur is also there. Right. So, this is the case, if you see. Delhi, Mumbai, right, you can see Delhi, Mumbai, this six cities, Delhi, Mumbai, Pune, Nagpur, Chennai and Ahmedabad. From these six cities, they are not allowing people to come through flights. Who decided this? Sir, Bengal government. It means they are okay with Hyderabad? Yes, sir. They are okay with Bangalore? Yes, sir. They are okay with, let's say, Chandigarh? Yes, sir. But they are not okay with these six cities. So, they have made a plan. What I am trying to say, this is called as, the topic called as distribution of power. Powers has been distributed to central government also and state government also. Jatin is asking, sir, can with the state revoke the discretion of central? No. They cannot revoke. They can implement that, they can exceed that in a better way, but not revoke. Let's say state government is saying that you cannot open the gym, but they say no, we will open. No, like, it's not like that, but they say okay, you can open the gym now, but they say no, we want to control it for another 2 months. That's beautiful. But here initially lockdown and everything, when the government of India took decision, it will be followed to everyone. Because there are some matters which is applicable to the whole India, some matters applicable to the state government also, right? Then Supreme Court Constitution, judiciary is independent, written constitution, these all are the features which are of features of federal. Now, if you read this paragraph, you will repeat everything. Which government we have? Union and state. I am not supposed to teach you what is union government, what is state government, right? So, we have different governments in the country. Then we have different courts. I told you, we have high courts, we have the supreme courts, but before high court, supreme court, we have so many lower level of courts, like we have district courts, we have the civil courts, we have the small cost courts. So, we have multiple levels of courts in our country where you file a case in the beginning, and when you lose the case in that court, you can appeal to the higher court, and this is how you go and appeal to lastly. If I give you homework, and if I ask you the highest case, there are two famous cases in India recently. The one case was of Nirbhaya rape case, and second one was Ayodhya Mandir. Ayodhya mein jo Ram Mandir ban raha hai, Ayodhya Ram Mandir, and that Muslim and Ram Hindu ka jo fight chal raha hai, that is the topic in Ayodhya, and Nirbhaya rape case in Delhi 2012, and this thing, two cases. Can you tell me which court Nirbhaya rape case was filed initially and which court Ayodhya case was filed? Logically, many people will say, so these are the two high profile cases and they would have filed in directly Supreme Court. But answer is no. These cases have not been filed in Supreme Court. Though, when you see the names of these cases, you will understand that, sir, these are the very high profile cases. They should be given immediate justice. And if you go to a lower court and you file the case in for 5 years in that court, then you will appeal to the higher court, then higher court, then higher court. So, it will take 25-30 years to get a justice. So, in this case, there should be a provision that we should file to Supreme Court, but answer is no. These cases were not filed to Supreme Court. These cases were filed to some other courts. That is the beauty of this too, because Ayodhya is in UP. It's a state matter. And that too also not in UP complete. In UP, we have a place called as Ayodhya. In that Ayodhya, we have a small location of some small area. It's not a whole Ayodhya. I don't remember the exact square feet, but there is some 10,000 square feet plot only about that. So, it is not a very big case for the people, for the law, they say. But emotionally, the whole India was involved. The whole Hindus and whole Muslims are involved in that case. But if you see the location, it is small, what to say, land, that's it. And if you see the Nirbhaya rape case, what is the problem? Only six people were there and they raped one girl, that's it. Only seven people are involved. Does it hurting 130 crore people? No, sir. What no? It is hurting 700 crore people of the whole world. In whole part of the world, nowhere rape is allowed. And that also such type of brutal, it is a serious crime and should be given justice in Supreme Court immediately. But the irony of the law is that they have filed to the lower court. Why I am saying all this thing? Because we have a hierarchy of court. And that is written in the constitution. And who is the best source? That is constitution. The topmost authority is Constitution of India. It is also known as mother of all laws, right? So I have told you all this thing earlier also. So this is thing, everywhere the case is being filed in the lower court, and then we approach to the higher court and higher court and the higher court like this. Right, guys? So I hope in this half hour we discuss the concept of unitary government as well as the federal feature, right? If I give you for the writing, I will request you to kindly note it down from here. Right, this is something for you. I am giving you 2-3 minutes to note it down. What are the unitary features and what are the state features? Quickly write it down. This is the best answer to understand. I am giving you 2-3 minutes to write it down. Either you can write it down or you can take a snapshot of this quickly. Thank you, Rajashree. Thank you, Janrath. Happy Guru Purnima. Yes, today we is Guru Purnima. In our mythology, we treat Lord Shiva. The ancient stories and all this thing, that Lord Shiva was the first Guru, and then Bhagwan Buddha was there, and then accordingly today teachers and the parents all are treated as Guru. So thank you very much to all the people. Thank you very much. Yeah, these are the federal and unitary features. Quickly note it down. Federal features, I told you we have a dual authority, that is dual government. I hope you remember this, dual authority. Then we have distribution of power, union and state, I told you. So powers are divided into this, supremacy of Constitution of India, judiciary and constitution, like this. These are this thing. But then I told you, single authority, when it is in case of emergency, the power will be always in the parliament. And I told you also, in India we have citizenship, single citizenship, unlike in the case of USA. What happens in USA? They have a multiple citizenship. But in India we follow that. So this left side is basically federal and right side is basically unitary. But if you understand, majority goes to federal. So that is why it is written. You can write it down also, the statement which can be asked in the exam also like this. So we can always say that Indian constitution is basically federal, having some, like, this is the final verdict to understand, remember, right? Yeah, please quickly note it down. 1-2 minutes more, 9:35 will start. I am giving it 2 minutes to note it down. If you are done, then please let me know so that we will start ahead. Right? Should we go ahead? Yes, Rani, thank you. Perfect. Now let's understand the concept of fundamental rights, right? If you see your notes, we have this flowchart also which is given in your notes, right? But before this flowchart, we will understand first of all the concept of fundamental rights. So what is fundamental rights? I hope you have heard in your childhood also, when you have studied the concept of civics, civilization, and social science, you have studied all this thing. So you have heard about all this thing, that a person gets what? The fundamental rights from the birth. From the birth, I hope you can read it out also. A man by birth has certain rights which are universal and inalienable. What is meaning of these two words? Universal means it is applicable everywhere, and what is meaning of inalienable? That is, you cannot give up these rights, you cannot surrender these rights, right? Yes, Jatin Ahuja, great Jatin. Ayodhya case was filed in Allahabad High Court, and then after Allahabad High Court, the case went to Supreme Court like this. And similarly, if you talk about the Nirbhaya rape case, that was filed in a Session Court. So, Session Court is a court lower than the High Court. So, you filed a case to the Session Court, then after that, those criminal appealed to the High Court, then the criminal appealed to Supreme Court. That's why the judgment came after 7 to 8 years. Why? Because of the system of our country. So, that is the irony of our country's law system. But anyways, we need to understand and we need to appreciate that also. So, okay, a man by birth, I told you, has certain rights which is inalienable and universal. So, when I say universal, it means universal, applicable everywhere, and the main word is inalienable. So, you cannot give up. So, let's say Likhita comes to me, Tushar sir, I will give you my rights. You take the rights from my side. And then every student says, Tushar sir, you are my guru. Today is Guru Purnima. So, we all the people who are watching the video, we all are giving our rights to vote. Because you have a right to vote, na? So, you give all the rights to vote to me. Is it possible? No. Is it possible? No. You say, Tushar sir, we give you the right to marry. So, what do you want? That your rights to marry, the 23 rights I will take and I should marry for 23 times? No. Thank you very much. So, these are not the provisions like this, that you cannot actually alienate your rights, not the rights to contract, right to vote, right to have power to sue. And if you have a right to sue, if you have a right to file a suit, you will only file a case, not anyone else can file a case on your side, right? So these are some rights which are being given to the person. It is a functional state to recognize those rights and allow them free play. What is free play here? It means basically no one should obstruct that free play, so that human liberty is preserved, human personality is developed, and overall effective, cultured, social and democratic life is promoted. So, I hope you understood this whole paragraph in simple language, that the rights should be given in such a way that everyone should get the advantage of the rights and everyone should enjoy the benefits of the fundamental rights, right? No one should be deprived from that, no one should be kept separated from that, no one should be state should make sure that they should always make sure that the rights to be given to the citizen of the country, and they should not be transferred or taken from the people, right? Sorry. Right? I hope you understood this. So, similarly, we have the 6 rights which we can talk about. The same thing is given in your notes also, right? Same thing, right of equality will start from this: equality, freedom, exploitation, religion, educational and cultural, and the 6th one is called as constitutional remedy, right? So, we will understand all the rights one by one, all the rights one by one. First is called equality. For this, we have article number 14 to 18 articles. I will tell you what is articles. So, articles are the sections, different points. For every point, they have made a separate article. So, article 370, you all are aware about last year. Article 370, which was giving the Jammu Kashmir a separate power, that article has been removed in Constitution of India. So, similarly, we have different articles, but since you are into CSEET, it is not in detail for you people. When you go to CS Executive, we again have this subject, this chapter in your JIGL. The subject called as Jurisprudence and Intervention of Statutes and General Laws, right? you have in that subject also, you will cover in executive. Right now, in this, you have just an introduction, right? Freedom of speech, freedom of expression, all the freedom we will cover. Then right against exploitation, so that everyone has a right that they should not be exploited. Then they have a right to religion, I told you that day also that if I can see name of someone, I can't see the name actually, everyone, okay, fine. But let's say I want to propagate Muslim religion. Can I do that? Can I go to the church? Can I go to the masjid? Can I go to the, what do you say, Gurudwara? Yes, sir. Can a Muslim comes to Gurudwara? Can a Muslim goes to temple? Yes. So everyone has a fundamental right to all this thing, right? This is the beauty of this fundamental right, that right of religion is there. It is, okay, this is article number 19 to 22, 23 and 24, two articles are there. Then 25 to 28 is there, and then 29-30 is cultural, 29 is cultural, educational is 30. These are the two rights, and then the last one is article number 32, right of constitutional remedy. So let me tell you in nutshell, actually, if I tell you, basically every people is given this five rights, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and normally very less people use this right. So why? Because the moment you have five rights, equality, focus on the five words, equality, freedom, exploitation, fourth one was religion, and the fifth one was educational and cultural right. If all the five rights are been followed properly, all the five rights has been proper followed properly, five rights, then no one will get this sixth right ever. There is no need to go for the remedy. Let's say I am teaching you properly, you are studying properly, you are paying fees, you are doing homework, I am teaching you. So what will happen after 1 or 1.5 months? We will end our course. You will study properly, you will pass exams, and there will be happy ending. You will not file a case on us, we will not file a case on you. And similarly, in India, there are many contracts, many things which has been followed beautifully. But whenever a person has been deprived from his rights, whenever I do something by which I take your right, I snatch your rights, and that time you can always file a case on us. We can file a case on you. But is it our case will come under fundamental rights? No. So I'll tell you that slowly. Understand right now. So we have six rights: right of equality, freedom, exploitation, religion, then cultural, educational, and the right of sixth one, that is called as the constitutional remedy. Right? Okay. Again, I told you everything. In the PPT also, part number 3, I hope you remember, part number 3, this one, right, part number 3, I told you. So this slide is also very important to understand that fundamental rights has been given to a person by birth, which has been told to you. Okay. So I told you right to equality, article number 14 to 18, which will cover, then freedom, right, then 23-24, exploitation, 25-28, religion, 29-30 educational, and 32 is this. So I hope you can remember everything, and by this end of the class, or maybe by 2-3 days, by the time we will end this chapter, you will understand all the rights properly, right? There will be no confusion. You will understand all this thing, and I will not make you to mug up all this thing. I will explain you the logics and everything, and you will remember forever, right? Anyways, so these are the rights, and these are the decoding of these rights, right? All this thing. And there was article number 31, which was guaranteed earlier, right to have the property everywhere, right? That has been amended and removed in this thing. Now the right of property is not a fundamental right, it is only legal right. What is legal right? It means you need to fight it. So whatever happened in the case of Ram Mandir, Ayodhya wala case, Muslim and Hindu, what was the case? What is the fundamental right? No, sir, it was a case of legal right. They fought a case and they won. Someone won, someone will win, someone will lose. It's a fundamental right. It's not a fundamental right now. It's a legal right. You need to fight for that, right? So these are just things. But very important thing, we need to understand that this is very important point. Article 12 and 13 is very important to discuss with the concept of state. Because very important thing, all the fundamental rights are available against state. Right now, why I am saying all this example? Now let me give an example to you people. I am not able to see the name of anyone. Let me see someone. Okay, I am not able to see any name of any person in our class. Yeah, right, we have a name, Shabnam. Shabnam is a student, she has commented in the beginning of the class also, Shabnam. Now focus on my example, what I am trying to say. Now Shabnam, as the name suggests, she is Muslim. Now please understand my example and focus on my example very carefully. Now let's say, I said in my example that I, Tushar Pahade, will not allow Muslim in my these two names. One is called Book My Lectures and one is called Tushar Pahade Classes. Okay? These are the two banners of me. So, I will not allow any Muslim. Now, understand this example. Please do not start riots and all. Dange mat karna bhaiya. Marna bhi mat mujhe. Bas samjho mere example ko. I said, I will not teach Shabnam and all the people who belongs to Muslim category. I don't teach Muslim. I am a Kattar Hindu and I only want to teach Hindu people. Please tell me in the comment section, can Shabnam first of all, if she is watching video right now, and other people also tell me, can these people file a case on me? Can Muslims file a case on me, Tushar Pahade, for the violation of fundamental right? Because Tushar Pahade is keeping them away from this right number 2930. Which one, sir? Right of education. I am not allowing them education. I am not allowing these people education, and I am saying no, I don't want to teach these people. Can I do that? Can I do that and can you people file a case on me if I do that? Can you do that? Can you file a case? Everyone is saying yes. Everyone is saying yes. Great. So it means you mean to say, I, Tushar Pahade, an individual person, private person, will not be able to discriminate on this part, and I cannot say Shabnam not to continue the class. I guess Shabnam has left the class. Anyways. Achha, it's a violation of right of equality. Great. Jatin is saying, it's a violation of right of equality also. Yes. It's a violation of right of equality also. Great. It's not religion. It's not religion. It is equality, 14, and also educational right. I am not allowing her the education properly. Okay, anyways, quickly tell me. Okay, now Hetvi messaged something. She said, I guess religion. I said, Hetvi, I guess you are a girl and I don't like girls. I don't want any comment from girls. Rather than from tomorrow onwards, I will not teach girls. Jatin Ahuja is good, Sandeep is good, right? Ashish is good. I will teach to the boys only. I am a male chauvinist person. Like the females are feminist, so I am a male chauvinist. And I am very much fond of, male rights, and I will teach male only. Females I will not teach. From tomorrow in my class, no female should sit. Don't take it literally, don't take it literally. Just understand the example. First of all, I am asking you, can I do this? If yes, can you file a case on me? Tushar sir, you are doing discrimination on the basis of this gender or discrimination on the basis of religion. That Hindu you will teach, you will not teach Muslims. You will teach Hindus, you will not teach, the Christian and all. Can I do all these things? First question. And can you file a case on Tushar Pahade classes or you can say Book My Lectures? I hope you are able to understand my topic and please communicate. Please put answers on this because it is very important to understand. Please comment. Fine. So let me tell you, all the answers of yours is wrong. Aap mera kuch nahi bigaad sakte. Let me repeat one more time. Aap mera kuch nahi bigaad sakte. I can do anything. You cannot file a case against me? Let me tell you, answer, you cannot file case against me. If you go to file a case against me, the court will not take up your case. Saying this, Tushar Pawar, it's his personal right. It's his choice. Let's say it's like it's her choice. Right? Akash is saying she will also have a right. It's her choice. Similarly, court will say, Tushar, it's your choice. I will meri marzi. Mujhe padhana main padhaunga, nahi padhana nahi padhaunga. Kisko? Ladkiyon ko ya Muslimon ko. Now ye example hai, samjhiye. Please understand. Take it in a good sense, do not take it in a wrong sense. Why I am saying all this thing? Can Tushar Pawar discriminate between Hindu Muslim? Yes. Can I discriminate between Hindu Muslim? This male female? Yes. Can it do discrimination between general category and open category? And this SCST? Yes. I will say, koi banda SCST mere se nahi padega. Because this SCST gets reservation from the people, they get all these advantages. I will only teach which people? Open category. I will teach open category people. General category people. Can I do this? Yes. So let me tell you example quickly. Can Tushar Pawar classes and BML do discrimination on religion, race, caste, sex, all these things? And same question, if I ask you that if you approach to ICSI to take admission, ICSI or let's say any college, can they say ICSI, can the ICSI say we will only teach Hindu? Can they teach, we always teach the people who are not black? Can they do in the race? Can they say on Brahmin, only teach Brahmin? Only teach male? Can ICSI say all this thing? Can college say all this thing? Now you will understand what I am trying to say. I guess you are not able to see this thing because I have kept like this. Okay. Now you will be able to see this. Yeah. Now you can able to see the screen. If TPC and BML discriminate religion, race, caste, sex, can we discriminate? Yes. Can ICSI say we'll only teach Hindu? No. Brahmin? No. Only the male people? No. But can Tushar Pawar say only main ladkon ko padhaunga, I will not teach girls? Answer is yes. And you cannot do anything against me. Trust me, main jo bol raha hu sach bata raha hu aapko, sunne acche se. Aap mere khilaf kuch nahi kar payenge. Religion, I will teach only Hindu. I will not teach Muslim. What you can do? What Muslim people can do? They can create riots. They can go and they can... Rani Sundar, I'll come to your answer. That's the beauty. Let me teach completely and you will understand and you will appreciate everything. Right? Let me teach completely. So, if I say only Hindu, not Muslims, what Muslim can do? They can bring so many people and they can try to hit me. Then that will create riots. Jo hote the, hamesha hote hain India mein hamare. Wo ho sakte hai. But can they file a case? No. No. I will say, sir, no. No, only casteism. I am promoting casteism. Only Hindus, yeah, not Hindu actually. See, Brahmin log padhenge. General log padhenge. SCST bilkul nahi padhenge. Is it a discrimination? Yes, sir. But can Tushar Pawar do? Yes, sir. Will I do? No. I am not doing all this thing. I have to samjha raha example. Samjhi meri baat ko. Kya main aisa karunga? Kabhi nahi karunga. But can I do? Yes, sir. And can you file a case on me? No. Can you hit me? Yes, sir. That is beyond law. But as per law, you can't file anything on me. Right? And this male, female, I can say, only females I will teach or only male I will teach. I can discriminate. Now, Rani is asking, sir, why? The question comes is, why? I request you to kindly tell me the answer. Why it is written ICSI? When I am saying ICSI, ICC and college, then it is written they cannot discriminate. Tushar Pawar and BML can discriminate. Can you find out the logic behind this? I'll ask you to find it out the logic behind this. If I talk about TPC and BML, can they do? I said yes, sir, they can discriminate. But if I am asking you ICSI, answer is no. Can you find out the trick between this? Very easy answer. Very easy answer. Let me see, Rani Sundar, because you are asking me why. Can you try the answer? What do you think? What do you think? Even you are wrong, that's okay. Good, Jatin. TPC is a private establishment. I am a private party. Good. Anyone, any more people who will try? Yes. Yes. ICSI is an organization, it cannot operate in a personal opinion. Yes, it's an organization funded by Government of India. Funded by Government of India. ICSI is a body, it's a statutory body. Yes, Rani, private and public, beautiful. Private, TPC is private, Tushar Pada class is private, BML private. ICSI colleges, colleges are run by universities. Universities are funded by central government or state government. Central government, state government. Tushar Pahade classes, private organization. Meri marzi. Main jo chahu karu. I will do whatever I want. Meri marzi. You cannot stop me. You cannot direct me. You can request me, but you cannot force me. So if I say from tomorrow I will not teach Muslims, it's just an example. I will never say like this. But if I do say this, you can't do anything against me legally. Illegally, you can do anything. You can do multiple things. You know this. But legally, you don't have a remedy to file a case on me. This is all the topic of whatever I taught you is a topic of state. It's a topic of state. It's a topic of state. And that's why if anyone wants to study this topic, he or she needs to understand, he needs to understand the concept of state. Anyone who wants to understand this subject, he or she need to understand article number 12, that is called a state. And law says, with few exceptions, read this line very importantly. I will read this for four times. With few exceptions, means only keeping 4 to 5 examples, aside, all the fundamental rights are available against state. I repeat one more time. With few exceptions, all the fundamental rights are available against states. One more time. All fundamental rights are available against state. All fundamental rights are available against state. And now the question is, what is state? What is state? We will understand these some points. This one and this one. And for this, we have a case of Ajay Hasia. I told you also in this case, Ajay Hasia versus Khalid Mujib. Ajay Hasia versus Khalid Mujib, 1981, same, AIR, 1981, Supreme Court, 481. Now you will understand, the case was filed by Ajay Hasia and was against Khalid Mujib. What was the case? I will tell you. And then the case was All India Reporter, 1981. And Supreme Court ka case tha ye. And that case, it was given judgment. And we have this test. We have this 6th test. I call it as a test. If Tushar Pahade classes, understand my point, if TPC comes under these 6 points, then you can file a case against me, and if not, then you cannot do anything against me. So what is state? What is state? So state means, understand, the first is the government and parliament of India. Look, unless the context otherwise require, the state includes what? The first of all, the government and parliament of India. You can say, can you say parliament of India means CG? Central government? Yes, sir. Then second is government and legislature of each state. So can you call it SG short may? Yes, sir. And third is called as all local authority. Can you call it LG, local government? Yes, sir. So I gave you the hint last video also. There are 3 governments in our country. Central government, state government, local government. Central government run by Modi ji, BJP government. State government based on different, like I stay in Maharashtra, so we have Uddhav Thackeray, Shiv Sena, but then I belong to Nagpur, and Nagpur we have a mayor, and every city has a mayor, local government, municipal corporation, improvement trust, yes or no? Yes, that will come into local governments. And do you think Tushar Pahade classes is either a central government or state government or local. What is Tushar Pada classes? So no one. But ICSI sir, comes under central government. University is a state government. Are you getting my point? Tushar Pada classes comes under what? Central government? State government? What? Local government? No sir, Tushar Pada classes, book my lectures, we are a private authority. We can do whatever we can do. Meri barzi. Jo karna main karunga. Jo karna karunga. Main kal se bolunga, I will not teach females. I will not teach Muslims. You cannot do anything legally. Main bar bar bol raha hu, you cannot do anything legally against me. Illegally, you all can come to my city and you can beat me up. De dhanadhan, maar diya mujhe. Wo theek hai, that's okay. But legally, case, nahi bhai. Not possible to file a case. Right? Are you getting my point? The expression local authority means what? Maine bata diya aapko. It will include municipality. I told you municipalities, district boards, panchayat, port, improvement trust. I told you. Improvement trust. Nagpur mein we have NIT, Nagpur Improvement Trust. NMC we have, Nagpur Municipal Corporation. Or we have BMC, I told you, Bombay Municipal Corporation. Or Kanpur would be there, Allahabad would be there, Delhi, DDA, Delhi Development Authority. So we have this municipal corporations and all these things. This will come under what? All these concepts, right? Mining Settlement Board, all these things. So court decides that who will, law has decided, and Constitution says in Article 12, the whole rights, whatever rights we have given, are against only states. But the first word starts with few exception. What is the meaning of these few exceptions? With few exceptions. With few exceptions. All the fundamental rights are available against state. With few exceptions. All the fundamental rights are available against states. So you can say 96% or 98% cases, the rights are available against state. It means we have some 2 to 4 exceptions. We have some exceptions where can you file a case against me? Yes, sir. Now, one example I will give you is example of this one. Right against extradition. Right against extradition. Now, I will teach you later on this topic, but I will tell you in this, we have an example of expression of woman and expression of children. Woman and children. So let's say I am doing something. Jispe ki mere ghar pe, I am at my home. I am employing a person who is of 12 years of age. Ek ladke ko, chotu ko maine appoint kiya apne ghar mein. Sunna mera example. At my home, there is a chotu. The age of that chotu is 12 years, and he is kept in my house just to do the cleaning work, saaf safai karna, bartan dho dena. 12 saal ka bachcha hai. I kept him. Or I am involved into the system of beggary. Beggary matlab bhikari. I am appointing, not appointing actually, I am, you have seen the movie Slumdog Millionaire? That scene I am using to explain myself, just to put example. That what I am doing is, I am trying to kidnap the children of different cities, and I bring them to the one city, let's say Mumbai. Mumbai is a very big city. And then I am trying to do some, incident with those people, like unki aankhein nikal li maine, I had to extract those eyes. It looks very cheap and dirty, but just understand example, because you have seen that movie Slumdog Millionaire. So I am doing all this thing, kisi ka haath kaat diya, kisi ke pair kaat diya, and I am making them to go into the system of beggar. If I am doing this thing, and if I caught, mujhe kisi pakad liya, can they file a case on me? No, Tushar sir private hai, koi case nahi honga. If I am appointing a children in my house, if I am doing appointing a children in my house, doing the housework or in my all this thing, can they file a case or they cannot file a case? Yes or no? Child labor. Yes, perfect answer, Rani. Child labor. And any person who is below 14 years of age, I will teach you everything later on. Any person whose age is below 14 is called a child, and if you do child labor, let me see if it will be written here only somewhere. This one. Let's see. Explanation. No child below the age of 14 years will be employed to work in a factory, mine, or engage any hazardous employment. In that case, can you file? Yes, you can. Can I say, Tushar Pahad is a private person, मैं किसी का हाथ काटू कि पैर काटू, मेरी मर्जी. And the 14 is basically into traffic in human being. Traffic in human being. We will cover that also in future. What is traffic in human being? Can you tell me the answer of this word? Traffic in human being. Have you heard about this? Traffic in human being. Anyone? Quickly. If I involve in the business of traffic in human being, trafficking. Any guess? Have you seen the movie Agnipath? Slavery, human smuggling, perfect Vasudev. Human smuggling, Manas, good, slavery, but slavery is okay, one person, but better word is the selling of men and women as a goods. Selling of traffic in human beings. If I show you like this, you'll understand what I'm trying to say. Right? I hope you can see the images and you'll understand what I'm trying to say. What's the meaning of traffic in human being? And majorly you will see the images of females. That's what written here. I've written here the concept of woman normally. Right? You'll see the images of women majorly. Human trafficking. So what is human trafficking? Selling the men and women as a goods. Normally the women are sold for prostitution. Let's say ek ladki ko kidnap kar liya kahin se gaon se. You have seen in multiple times news mein, paper mein, sab taraf padhne milta hai that a female from Bihar has been kidnapped and then she has been sold to someone in Mumbai at 15,000 rupees, 20,000 rupees. So this is bad. It is used for prostitution, right? So this is wrong. And if Tushar Pahad is involved on this thing, can you people file a case on me? Or can I say, I am not a government, I am not a state, I can do all this thing. Sir, can you do all this thing? Sharam aane chahiye sir aapko. I will be behind bars. In this example, this statement will not applicable that fundamental rights are available against state. No. It's a crime. It's a serious crime. Serious crime. And in that case, Tushar Pahade or any person will go in jail. Punishable offense. So at that time, you will not able to say these words that, sir, it is my wish, my choice, meri marji. Like, it is not in that case. So understand what I am trying to teach you. Why I am teaching you in detail? Because you need to understand everything in proper way, right? Okay, where was the topic? This one. I hope you understood this meaning of the word. Right. Let's understand this sixth test. Please understand. Supreme Court has enunciated the following test to determine whether the entity is state or not. So whether Tushar Pahad classes or Book My Lectures comes under state or not. Whether TPC or BML comes under state or not. Yes or no. It all depends on the sixth test, whether TPC or BML comes under this category. So first of all, if the entire share capital, underline main words, you will understand everything. Entire share capital of the corporation is held by government. So do you think TPC and BML, the funding, the capital is held by central government? Aapko lagta hai ki Tushar Pahad classes ka paisa kahan se aata hai? Central government se or state government se? Do you think so? If you think yes, then I am a state. But reality, you know that we are a private body. We are just into teaching. Agar hum log government of India hote, to hame paas 25 bacche nahi padhte hote. I would have not taught till not 25-30 students. I would have taught to 10,000 students. I would have been ICSI, but I am not ICSI. I am a private body, sir. My funding is not done by ICSI or central government or state government. So first thing you need to see whether it is funded by capital. First is capital. Second one is financial assistance. Financial assistance to meet the expenditure. All the expenses of marketing, videos, studio, software, everything. If it is borne by Tushar Pahade himself by taking money from you people, then it's a private organization. But if you think that it has been funded by ICSI or by central government, then I am a state. But you know the reality. Point number three, the control. Three we can take when the corporation enjoys monopoly. Main word is here, monopoly. Do you think Tushar Pahade classes has been a monopoly in teaching CS course by ICSI? Have you got any message from ICSI saying that Tushar Pahade classes are the authorized teachers for CSET ever? Have you got any SMS from ICSI? Have you got any mail from ICSI saying that Tushar Pahade classes is the authentic coaching center? Yes or no? Have you got any message from BML, from ICSI saying that Book My Lectures are the authentic and monopoly organization of BML? Have you got ever? No, and you will get never also. And do you know there are many institutes who are teaching CS course? Pata hai apko na, bahut sare log padha rahe hain. Many people are there who are teaching, and we are not exclusive. We are also part of the system. There are multiple people who are teaching in India. We are also part of that. We are not getting the monopoly. But let's say, please understand. Very, very beautiful example. If ICSI sends you an email saying that BML, Book My Lectures, are our organization, ICSI's organization. Understand my point. Book My Lectures, controlled by Tushar Pahade, ICSI sends you an email saying that Book My Lectures is a part of Tushar Pahade classes and they manage this, and you can join exclusive classes with Tushar Pahade classes. And if you are doing all this thing with BML or TPC, it means you are doing with ICSI. Can we people at that time do this discrimination of religion? Can we do this casteism? Can do this point of male female that time? When we will be authorized by ICSI, can that time we people do all this thing that we will not teach Muslims, we will not teach Hindu, we will not teach SCST, we will not teach females? Can we do that time? That time? Answer is never. Because that time we will be a state. That time we will be, which will never happen. I'm just giving example. Now don't take it in a different sense. Ki Tushar sir to kuch aur bol rahe. No, I'm just giving example that if it happens, then I will not be state. But you know this will never happen. And forever, TPC will be what? TPC will be what? A private organization. I am not a state. Because my TPC is not getting any finance from ICSI. We are not getting any control from ICSI. We are not getting any monopoly from ICSI. We are not getting any share capital from ICSI. So when ICSI is not supporting us in this all this sense, then how and why we become what? The state. So I hope you understood this. We have to understand this test, right? So whether the corporation enjoys a monopoly status, if they enjoy, then they will be state. If they do not enjoy, they are not the state, right? Then I told you fourth point, control. Deep and pervasive control. Deep control. Deep means till the lower level, from top level, middle level to lower level. The complete control. When you say deep means like this, vertical, from top to bottom. What is pervasive? Pervasive means like this, at all levels, everywhere. So government has deep and pervasive control over the affairs of the business. So whatever we are doing, let's say BML says when to announce batch. Understand? We said we will have a batch from 1st July 2020. We will give first 5 days what? Demo. These 5 days, the fees would be how much? 8,000. From 6 July, if anyone joined, the fees would be how much? 12,000. These are planned by, please tell me, these all things in BML, that from 1st to 5 days, we will have demo and we can pay the fees of how much? 8,000 rupees. From tomorrow, 6 July, if you register, the fees would be how much? 12,000 rupees. All these things has been said to us by Government of India or we people decided. Tell me, if you go to our website, right, Book My Lectures, and then if you go to this CSEET, so you can see this, the price is how much price? 12,000 rupees. Now I will edit it, within 2 minutes I will edit it, and the price is 12,000, but I will make it 8,000 rupees, because today is the last day to register for 8,000 rupees. So I will do it. Now, do you think I will do it or ICSI will do it? Will I do it or will ICSI will do it? Or will the Government of India will do it? Sir, I will do it, because I have a control of this business. Tomorrow I will increase it to 15,000 rupees. Right now it is 8,000 till today. From tomorrow we will make it 12,000 rupees. So it is our wish. We are a private organization. But if the control is of ICSI, what they would have said, do like this. Do you think they have a control on us? No, they do not have a control on us. Are you getting my point? So these are the examples to understand what I am trying to teach you, and this is a beautiful thing to understand, right? And the last one, if the work of the government, corporation is of public importance and related to the government functions. What is government function, sir? What the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Rail is doing. If our functions resemble closely related to the functions of government, then we will be part of. But are we doing it charity? No. Are we doing for charity? No. Are we charging fees? Yes, sir. Why we are charging fees? Because we are not Government of India. Are you getting my point? And lastly, it has been department which has been transferred to a corporation. Were the TPC or BML was a part of government earlier, which has been transferred? No. So what are the 5 examples which I taught you? Okay. First one was the complete share capital. Okay, I'll make the changes. I'll write it sequence wise. The first one was share capital. Second one was the financial assistance or help, right? Third one was monopoly status. Fourth one was the control. Fifth one was the functions of the state. Do you think our functions, BML, is doing charity? Are we doing help to you people, teaching you in a reasonable price? Yes, we are doing that. We are doing at a cheaper price. We are doing in a good level, everything. But do we teach you at free level? No. Because we also have to run the teaching and all this thing, and if we will charge some fees from you, we will be able to give you the good quality. Right? Free mein jo milta hai wo hamesha kharab hi hota hai. Cost to hoti sir, har cheez ki cost hamesha hoti hai. If you pay some cost, you will get good things. Right? So anyways, what I am trying to say, that functions, are we doing like charity and all? No sir. So do you think we are belonging to the government? No. And the last one is the business of the government, which is previously part of the government. Have you transferred from the business? No, sir. Our business was earlier also what? Please understand what I am trying to say. Our business was Department of Government, which transferred to corporation. So, were we associated with government earlier? And then we have been transferred to private BML, Tushar Padagasas? No, sir. We were private, from initially, a private organization. We were never the part of government. Right? So, this is how you need to understand. These are the 6 tests. I hope you understood this 6 tests perfectly. Right? Please give me the reply in the comment box, because it is very important point to cover up today, which we have covered, very important point, article number 12, which talks about the concept of state. And whether Tushar Pada classes or book my lectures is state or not, it depends on these six words. What about share capital? Right. Share capital. Who gives the finance? Do we have the monopoly status? Do the government has control? Do the functions of our business resembles to the functions of government of India? And the last one is, were we government earlier? If these 6 points, any of the 1 point, understand my point, very important, final verdict. If any of these six, any one out of these six is applicable to Tushar Pada classes or BML, we are state. And if we are state, the fundamental rights are available against us. One more time, I'll repeat. In Hindi also I will repeat, English also I will repeat. I'll repeat first of all in English one more time. If all the these 6 points which I have taught you, out of these six, if anyone is applicable to Tushar Pada classes or book by lectures, we will be called as state. And if we are covered under state, then the fundamental rights will be against us. At that time, we will not be able to do that whatever point I told you. Can I do distinction between Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, SI, religion, race, caste, or place of birth? Hindu, you belong to UP, you belong to this, or sex, that is the male or the female. We will not discriminate on this basis. But right now, do you think that Tushar Pada classes, TPC or BML, do you think any of the 6 points is applicable to we people? Just quickly answer me. Do you think any of the six points applicable to Tushar Pada classes or BML? Any of the six? Do you think? Yes or no? Jatin says no. Harsh says no. Some more answers, please. Do you think any of the 6 points? Any of the six? If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Tushar sir, I have a doubt. You can ask me right now. Do you think any question, any point which is applicable to Tushar Pada classes or BML? If yes, then I am a state. But if you think, Tushar sir, no sir, you do not fall under any of the category. Not the funding, not the finance, not the monopoly, no control, no functions, nothing is applicable to we people and we are not state. So, can we discriminate? Yes, sir. But not in all. We can do that. Perfect. Sabko samajh mein aa gaya kya bola maine? Okay, I am giving two options, discussion. One is Aaj Tak and dusra is BPCL, Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited, and first one is Aaj Tak News Channel. Are these two states or not? Or any one of them, this out of state, any guess? Out of these two, Aaj Tak, BPCL, I am giving you two names, Aaj Tak, BPCL, are both the states? Ronak says no, it means both are not states. Or Ronak is giving answer to the previous one, I don't know. Jatin Ahuja, second is state, BPCL. Yes. So finally answer is perfect. It is state. Yes. And many people are saying Aaj Tak is not a state. Vaise you are right, but you are not even aware that Aaj Tak mein funding is ki hai. Aaj Tak is not getting monopoly. Aaj Tak has no monopoly. Okay. But do you know the control? Because the people of Aaj Tak, all the news anchors of Aaj Tak only talks about BJP government. If you see Aaj Tak channel, they are never talking against BJP. and the news anchor Anjana Om Kashyap and Anjana Shweta Singh, all these people are very much talking in favor of BJP. Please understand, it is not so simple that I am asking you and you are giving me answer. You all are of around 18 years of age. Trust me, you all are not ever actually aware about all these things. You need to understand, the moment you said, yes sir, Aastak is not a state, you need to very much careful about these answers. You need to go and check it out first of all, that whether the funding is there by the government of India. It could be there. It could be there. It could be there. Right. If I talk about third example, LIC, is it a state? The answer would be yes sir, it will be a state. Why sir? Because it's written Life Insurance Corporation of India. It's a company which is like this. And then yes, Harsh Kaushik. Z News is also like of BJP. But because I'm saying that Z News is of like BJP or Aastak is on BJP only, is it meaning of that they are state? No. But can you deny also that they are not state? No. What I'm trying to just say is that you all are so small right now. Aap sab chote chote bachche ho. Aapki age 17 saal, 18 saal, 19 saal ki hai. Yahan pe baithe baithe video dekhte hue on the video within 2 minutes, you are no one to judge and tell right now whether they are state or not. So what you need to just say always that yes, these all three can be states. These all three can be states, this cannot be state also. It all depends on those 6 points. This is state, no doubt in that, this is state, no doubt in that. But what about Aastak? You don't know about this. Because can Aastak have a control? Can Aastak has a control by the government? Control. Right from top to bottom. You will only show such news. You will only show such news. Aap aisa nahi dikhana, waisa nahi dikhana. Can Aastak be controlled by government of India? Can it be possible? Just tell me answer yes or no. Can there is the possibility that Aastak is controlled by the controlled, huh? Not finance, not monopoly, nothing. Because do we have monopoly? Do we only one news channel? No sir, we have numerous news channel. But can Aastak have a control that the decision making power by government? Can. Yes, best answer is given by Jatin Ahuja. Yes, it can. Do we know it? No. Tushar sir, do you know this? No. But can, I am asking you can? Yes. So you need to check it out. You need to check it out. Aapko jaake check karna hoga. Tab you need to give answer. Not haphazardly. Right guys? So this is all about my side for today. We have covered beautiful topic today. Many things we have discussed today in around 1.5 hour. So I hope you understood this whole topic of state and what is all about this. NDTV किसका है? अरे अपने को मतलब नहीं उससे, कौन किसका है वो मतलब नहीं है. जिसका भी होगा, we need to find it out that whether we can do register or not, right? Thank you so much sir, and please edit the fees. Yes, fees is 12,000 rupees. I will make it 8,000 rupees right now. The moment I will end the video, I will edit it to 8,000 rupees. I request you to kindly go to my website, right? Just go and type book my lectures. The moment you type book my lectures, you will be able to see this logo pop up also. And if you can cross it, and if you can go to video lectures, and if you go to CS course, CSET, just go to CSET, you will see a course of CSET, right? And then you get a fees right now of 12,000 rupees, which is basically not 12,000 rupees, it is basically 10,000 rupees, right? So I request you kindly go and register yourself immediately so that you will get the access of the lectures from tomorrow, and you should get the proper knowledge which we are basically showing, right? Okay, meanwhile I am talking to you, I will make it right now only, right? Okay, so I have done it. And the meanwhile I was talking to you, I have done it basically. So if you just refresh it, right, if you just refresh it, you can see the price right now, right? So I have done it within 2 minutes. So it is also an example to say that we are not state, we can do right now. Within moment I can make it to 10,000, we can make it to 12,000. But right now the value, the level which are giving, the level which are teaching you, we are happily offering you the lectures at 8,000 rupees. Kindly go and register today, as it is the last day. tomorrow we will be making the fees for 12,000 rupees and then you may miss the level of quality which we are giving, right? Thank you guys. Register tomorrow, today only, please register, and whatever questions you have, you can ask me anytime which we have there, right? Yes, tomorrow we will be adding to the group, the people who have registered, we will adding to the groups and we will give you the lecture tomorrow from the group only, right? Perfect. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. And do like the video if you have enjoyed the session today of around 1.5 hours. I hope aapko bore nahi hua hoga. You would have enjoyed that. And this 1.5 hour has been, went very quickly. So do like the video if you can think that we have enjoyed this Sunday morning in a beautiful manner. So shower your love with us, right? Thank you. Thank you very much, guys. Bye-bye. Take care. Love you. See you tomorrow, right? Bye-bye. Thank you.